London inspires me a lot, and places and cities and the people in them. So I guess people, it's all very vague, but I like making up stories around things that I see. So I guess people and places and just events inspire me. I had a piece that I just wrote and I didn't really know what it was, but when someone just said, oh, you know, that's spoken word, that's a poem. And I was like, really? It doesn't look very good on the page. It doesn't rhyme in the way that it should. And they said, well, no, perform this. So I performed it. And one of the guys there just sent it off to the Roundhouse in Camden. And the Roundhouse has this amazing, amazing spoken word platform for young people. Like, it's brilliant. And I ended up going for the slam. And long story short, after 3 weeks, I ended up coming third. And it was just a massive shock to kind of be like, oh, okay, this counts as something. I never used to write about politics, really. I just kind of wrote stories about my life. And then slowly, things started to edge out because I've always been quite political. And it's been interesting seeing how, like, what topics you can touch on with different people. Things like sexism, that's really interesting because, like, it's got to a stage now because I've got a couple of poems about sort of feminism and women and how they're seen in society. And there was a period of time when I was just introduced at gigs as, like, Bridget Minamore, the black feminist. And I just got, and it started to really grate me. It was like a joke, but it was like, is this me? If I say one opinion, I'm suddenly feminist who's talking about issues to do with Africa and stuff. That's just suddenly who I've become. And I think the good thing about spoken word is that when you're going up on stage or show on a camera or whatever it is for 3 minutes, and it is only 3 minutes, and if someone doesn't like it, it's quite easy for me to be like, you know, I don't particularly, not that I don't care, but everyone's got different tastes and I can live with that. A 2-hour play is a bit different, but for my little stories I can be like, okay, that's fine if you don't like it, but if you do like it, it's brilliant.